Juan has a coupon for 15% off any purchase of $100 or more at the phone store. He wants to buy a new phone that cost $250. How much money will the coupon save Juan? Because the cost of the phone is $100 or more, Juan receives 15% off the purchase price of $250. Which means to determine how much Juan will save, we need to determine what is 15% of $250. And we'll show this two ways. We learned earlier, in order to find the percent of a number, we write the percent as a decimal by moving the decimal two places to the left, and of course removing the percent symbol. And then step two, we multiply the percent as a decimal by the whole amount. So to find 15% of 250, the first step is to write 50% as a decimal, which would be 0.15. 0.15 because as a percentage, the decimal point is to the right of the 5. Move it left two places, 1, 2. That gives us 0.15 or 0.15. So we have 0.15 times 250, which equals 37.5. And because the units are dollars, this means Juan saves $37.50 by using the coupon. Let's also go through the process of setting up a percent equation by first determining the percent, the base, and the amount. Where we know the percent has the percent symbol, or the word percent, the amount is part of the whole, and the base is the whole amount. So for this situation, the percent is 15%. Because we're looking for 15% of 250, or part of 250, the base or whole amount is the 250, and the amount is the unknown. Let's use the variable A to represent the amount. So now if we write the percent equation, which is percent times base equals amount, we get 15% times the base of 250 equals the amount A. Notice the left side of this equation is the same product we had to find the percent of a whole. 15% as a decimal is 0.15 times 250 equals A, so A equals, again we know this product is equal to 37.5. Whichever approach we take, we know that Juan saves $37.50. I hope you found this helpful.